Closed captioning for Maine Life is brought to you by...
Hi everyone, welcome to Magalian Rugs at 175 Anderson Street in Portland, Maine. A lot of our designers start with the rug. It's the foundation of the room. We do work with people on all budgets from lower end all the way to the higher end, whether you're looking for one or two rugs or a whole house full. Yeah, I'm the third generation in the rug business. I grew up around it. It's in my blood and I wouldn't trade it for anything.
Echo is the semblance of a sound, and I press and I've waited with my ear upon the ground.
Oh lover, I'll see you there, waiting in the willows with your autumn hair. Oh lover, I'll see you there after many miles.
Hi, I'm Andrew Silsby, President and CEO of Kennebec Savings Bank and proud presenting sponsor of Maine Life, a show that's dedicated to telling positive stories about life right here in Maine. Like many of you, I was excited to turn the calendar to 2021 and all the optimism it brings. If this is your year to change your banking relationship, don't hesitate to reach out to Kennebec Savings Bank. Our staff stand ready to assist you with all your financial needs. Click or call us today. We hope you enjoy this episode of Maine Life. Thanks for watching.
We're here at beautiful Falmouth Country Club this summer. We'll welcome 156 players from around the world welcoming back the PGA Tour to our great state.
Your lobster roll in particular is a do-it-yourself lobster roll, which I love.
We want to make sure everyone gets it the way they want it. So if you want butter, great. If you want the mayo, great. It's a great roll. The bread's amazing. Even down to the fries, we hand cut them here ourselves.
Cheers. We're looking forward to seeing everybody here in June.
Hi everybody, and thanks for watching this episode of Maine Life. As we know, in 2020, so many events were either canceled or postponed, but as our country begins to safely reopen, we are so excited and ready to see our friends again and to come together for events, whether it be live music or sports. And we are also excited to share with you that the PGA's Corn Ferry Tour will be happening here in the state of Maine at the end of June, right here at the Falmouth Country Club, who will be hosting the Live and Work in Maine Open. It is a very exciting event, not only for our state, but for living and working in Maine. And how it got that name, we're now going to introduce you to our friend. You may remember Katie Shorey, who works for Live and Work in Maine. Katie, so tell us about the impact that this tournament and the meaning really behind, you know, how it came all together.
I know, we're so excited to be part of this national tour. And really how it got its name is that the employer community and the sponsors that are behind it really wanted to rally around an economic incentive. And that's essentially what they're doing with the Live and Work in Maine Tour. We're trying to essentially say, look, Maine is known for quality of life and careers, so we're so excited to be part of it.
And it really stands out when you go to the PGA's website and the Corn Ferry Tour and you see all the different locations that these players will be going to, and then you see Live and Work in Maine. I think your mission accomplished.
Oh yes, I mean, I hope people will come to the site and really look at not only the jobs that we have, but the variety of places where you can live across the state. And we just want people to know, more people to know, that we want you to live and work in Maine. So we're just so excited.
And so how is business going through, you know, 2020, the pandemic, into this year?
It was a relationship building year and a really good press year. And we are just, we keep hearing from our partners, the employers, that they have jobs open. It's ramping back up like it was pre-COVID. So there are jobs, and there's a lot of activity going on. Companies moving here, companies growing. So it's gonna be a great year.
It's good to see you again.
Likewise, I know.
In person. Well, we are now gonna toss it over to the executive director of the Live and Work in Maine Open, our friend Brian, or as we call him, BC, to talk more about the thousands of people and the professional talent coming here to our state.
Thanks, Aaron and Katie. My name is Brian Cochran, executive director of the Live and Work in Maine Open. We're here at beautiful Falmouth Country Club, where on June 21st to the 27th this summer, we'll welcome 156 players from around the world welcoming back the PGA Tour to our great state. The critical component, as with any major event of this magnitude, is really finding the right partners, right? First, you need a home. So Falmouth Country Club, known in this region as one of our very best, presented an opportunity to bring the tournament here. Little did we know a pandemic would be upon us. So now we had an extra year to get it right, and we're more excited than ever this June to unveil the Live and Work in Maine Open for fans of all ages. This PGA tournament is going to drive significant impact to the region beyond the game of golf that's playing here. Obviously, the fans that'll be coming, yes, from our market, but hopefully many more tourists from shoulder markets. You know, we'll have our beloved Bites and Brews events that will be featuring that award-winning culinary and craft beer, as much as our Fan Fest, that whether you will be inside the ropes for golf action on our Club 19 chalet here or beyond, the Fan Zone itself is going to be a great festival attraction for fans of all ages. We kick off the week with our Party for Purpose. It's where we really raise a glass for all the sponsors and all our VIPs that have made this event possible, and also our beneficiary, the Barbara Bush Children's Hospital, as well as on Wednesday, we'll have our Pro-Am, where these best players in the world get a chance to play with us amateurs, right? An opportunity for foursomes to say someday, I played with one of the best in the world. And then we kick off tournament action Thursday through Sunday, June 24th through the 27th. We're grateful for Jeff Harris and his team, the countless hours they put in over the last 2 years to get this ready for the world stage. Speaking of partners, here's our friend Jeff Harris from Falmouth Country Club. Are we ready for the Live and Work in Maine Open?
Hello, everybody. Of course we are, BC. We've been hard at work at this for 2 years. We're so excited. The golf course is shaping up just tremendously. We can't wait for the event.
We're very excited at Shipyard to be part of a terrific event hosted by the Falmouth Country Club. There's a commemorative special brew that Shipyard has created for this event, and it's called Birdie Time IPA. It's an exciting, fun product. Hoppy beers are very exciting these days, and at a session strength of just 4.1%, you can easily enjoy a few out on the golf course and not suffer on your score. As a matter of fact, might loosen up that backswing a little bit, and maybe you'll get a few birdies in your round. And in addition to that, there's a terrific cause also associated with the event and the beer. And that is proceeds from the sale of the Birdie Time Session IPA from Shipyard will help support the Barbara Bush Children's Hospital here at Maine Medical Center in Portland.
I'd like to thank our friends from Shipyard for the official beer of the Live and Work in Maine Open, Birdie Time IPA.
Cheers. We're looking forward to seeing everybody here in June.
Whether you like your Dunkin' hot or iced, if you're into cold brew or espresso, Dunkin' has something for you. Don't leave without an item off the snacking menu and order ahead on the Dunkin' app. Maine moms, run on Dunkin'.
Hi everybody and welcome back. Well, so many of you are going to be tuning into the Live and Work in Maine Open for, of course, the professional premier talent coming to Falmouth. The organizers have been working so hard on preparing many meals and drinks for the event and different things that we can participate in. Chef Nick, you got this phone call a year ago, right? Or more than a year ago. So how excited were you to showcase some of your talents to not only the professional golfers, but the spectators?
We were really thrilled. So it was something that we can really showcase what we're doing on a daily basis to a huge spectrum of people that will be here for that week. And we've really felt like we've worked very hard to get the food to where we want it to be.
Your lobster roll in particular is a do-it-yourself lobster roll, which I love because, call me crazy, but I'm not a mayo fan. I love just drowning it in butter.
We want to make sure everyone gets it the way they want it.
Yeah,
that's a
great.
Huge part of it. When you're here, you know, we kind of have it your way. So if you want butter, great. You want the mayo, great. You don't want any of it, great. It's a great roll. The bread's amazing. Even down to the fries, we hand cut them here ourselves.
I've just been waiting to have one myself. Okay, so you're from New York originally, or is that where you came
my
from?
My culinary background's from there, yeah. I was lucky enough to be working for John George and his management team. I ran the Inn at Pound Ridge. In the Hudson Valley, and my wife and I came on vacation here, which is the story of so many chefs. We spent 4 or 5 days here, ate through the town, and we're just blown away between the food, the people, obviously the beauty of Maine. Mm-hmm. And from really that conversation ride home was, how do we live and work in Maine?
Yes. Live and work in Maine Open. There you go. Well, we are so excited, thankful for you and your talent, and excited to be part of this week. Yeah, whether you're a golfer, a fan, a spectator, or just want to eat some really good food and feel the energy again.
That's exactly right. I think it's going to be an amazing week.
I think good to see you again.
Great to see
Let's
you.
Let's cheers to a... Cheers.
Cheers.
And before we come back, a message from some of our sponsors who help make Maine Life happen and help us tell hundreds of local stories each year.
Put on a smile, hop in your ride, and take a ride on the easier side. Embrace the roads, enjoy the streets, and share a smile with everyone you meet. Pick up your neighbors and give them some love. Show the whole world we can rise above. Put on a smile, hop in your ride, and take a ride on the easier side.
Hi, I'm Mike Vail, president of Hannaford Supermarkets. I actually started at Hannaford coming out of college. I'm so proud of Hannaford because of of everything that the brand represents and the role we play in our communities, particularly here in Maine, where a 140-year company, Maine roots, started in 1883 with a produce wagon coming out of Cape Elizabeth. Our brand is greater than groceries, and we support our communities and in as many ways as we possibly can. Kind of the traditional places you might expect us to support: food banks. If our associates are getting involved with nonprofits, we try to support them in their endeavors with that nonprofit. And I also look back at all the work that we've done around diversity, equity, and inclusion at Hannaford. And we continue to sort of look at how can we adapt, train, teach, and create an environment that's positive for people to want to work and be part of the Hannaford team. For us and for those of us that are in this business and make it a career, we're very, very passionate about it and very proud of the brand that we represent every day in the state of Maine for our customers and our communities.
At Kennebec Savings Bank, we're not just a bank, we're a community bank in the truest sense of the word. We dedicate 10% of our income to go back to the communities that we serve. Last year, that amount totaled over $1.1 million. To 350 different organizations in 35 communities right here in Maine, all while our employees volunteered over 8,000 hours of community service. We're proud of our role in the community and hope you'll give us a try. Call or click Kennebec Savings Bank today.
One of my favorite parts of the job is being able to be in the office and in the field. Transmission lines are what gives people power. And if something happens to those transmission lines, whether it be a storm or it aging out, it's our job to fix it quickly. The utilities world and projects industry itself, construction is definitely a man's world. But I think I was just lucky enough to have good mentors. I am Nicole and I am CMP.
We could all stand to eat a little bit less salt in our diet, and I think that the way to accomplish that is by eating less processed food. Less fast food, less frozen food, less food in a box. It's very important that you use salt in your cooking. Nothing will make it taste better and more like itself. Salt as you go, season judiciously, and most importantly, taste as you go, so that you know the food that you serve to your friends and family tastes as good as you hope it does.
Hi, I'm George Fahey. I'm a junior at Waynefleet High School. Last year, I won the Maine State Class C High School Championship for golf. My family is a huge golfing family. Ever since my great-granddad picked up the game, he's kind of passed it down along through the family. And it's really exciting and really cool to have professional golf being played kind of in my backyard, to be able to hang out with these guys and watch them play practice rounds and watch the tournament take place. It's going to be really fun. I wasn't even alive the last time professional golf was played in Maine, so it's a big deal to get it back in the state. And I think the golf community in Maine really needs this, and it's going to be really exciting for them to see professional golf right at their window.
So as we mentioned earlier, the Live and Work in Maine Open coming here the end of June 24th through the 27th. We talked a little bit about golf, beer, culinary, and so many great things here in our state. Today I'm joined by Martha from Maine Department of Economic and Community Development, DECD. How are you, Martha?
I'm great. Thanks for having me, Brian.
Great. Well, we've talked a lot about golf and food and beer and lots of great things here in our state. What is happening at DECD these days?
There's a lot happening at DECD. We have so much work going on with implementing our strategic plan, and that includes great things around attracting new talent. You know, we have a lot of people, we call them people with affinities for Maine. You know, maybe they went to camp here, or they went to college here, or they have long-term family ties, but they don't always realize that there's really a place back here in Maine's workforce as well.
Right. So the golf industry's gone through a big boom. Private, public golf courses across the state taking full advantage of this great outdoor game. What other things does DECD have on their radar as it pertains to sport and maybe more so from the tourism lens?
Yeah, there's a lot going on with sort of outdoor recreation, both from the, you know, sort of all the experiences, but also recognizing that we're really building a lot of outdoor product brands as well. And that there's an opportunity to look at things like, you know, new materials being made with Maine forest products. So, you know, looking at nanocellulose as a way to change maybe your driver and your golf clubs and that sort of thing. Golf balls made with lobster shells that can then disintegrate if you hit them off of your cruise ship. So there's a lot of opportunities for connecting all of the various pieces of Maine's economy and recognizing that they're all very connected.
So we've signed a five-year deal with the PGA Tour to bring this event. Where is Maine going to be in 5 years from now, from your lens?
Yeah, I think in the next 5 years, Maine is going to still be a great place to live and work and play. But I do think that we're going to really see a much more diverse group of people living in Maine, people coming in and mixes of ideas. One of the nicest things with golf in Maine is that it really is one of our outdoor recreation opportunities. There are a lot of public golf courses, nine-hole golf courses, and don't forget disc golf. So it really is accessible to all. So we look forward to there being more Mainers in the next 5 years.
So we're committed for the next 5 years, hopefully 10 or more with the Live and Work in Maine Open. Thank you, Martha. We look forward to this collaboration with DECD.
Thanks for having me.
You can discover which fresh and flavorful Real Maine products are in season. Visit realmaine.com to explore the diverse Maine agricultural products that you can enjoy today.
MaineLife! And a big thank you to everybody involved with the Live and Work in Maine Open. We hope to see so many of you here in Falmouth at the end of June. Now switching gears, your Maine concierge Vanessa Santarelli and I have been hard at work. Our team is excited to hit the road for our summer series. We're bringing you to some great new places, but we also want to take a moment to remind you of where we were last year. So many of the businesses that we featured last summer were nervous, struggling, and we just want to remind you of other places in Maine where you can eat, play, stay, and enjoy our state. So take a look.
Hi everybody and welcome to Maine Life. We are so excited to finally be back hitting the road, bringing you on all of our new summer adventures. And what better way is there to experience our mountains, forests, gorges, and waterfalls than by going camping?
All right. Gigi, you're coming with us.
Going camping.
Hi, welcome to Lemo Eats. We are a food trailer located in Bethel, Maine. Our food is kind of like a take on modern American cuisine. Its main focus is like Southern American with Southeast Asian.
Well, we don't need to eat dinner tonight or breakfast tomorrow, I don't think.
Oh my word.
That's a nice kick for you.
All right, I gotta do the lean for this one, I think.
It's all you.
Do all over my face? Anything else?
Master fire starter.
Did you get it?
Master camper.
Cheers to a great summer and to Maine life, the best life.
We're in Congdon's Donuts in sunny Wells, Maine.
Cheers.
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 Here goes the taste test. Mm. I need a second bite of this one.
Oh, wow.
They say it's a tough job, but somebody's gonna do it.
Have you played with Paul before?
Once.
Yeah. His wife says he's really competitive.
I can say that's true.
I can say that's true.
Oh, look at the spin.
Yeah. Fancy.
Oh! Yeah!
We beat the teach!
You can go 20 miles an hour, but you cannot go that if you're only in level 2.
Do you want to race?
No.
Woo! This is cool.
Right?
Oh my gosh.
Concierge. Another adventure.
With my partner in crime.
Ah!
That looks like comfort, if I've ever seen comfort.
This is heaven on earth. People stop us at the gas station and they're like, love your show, you guys eat a lot.
Brad's homemade waffles with lovely, lovely berries, raspberry coulis underneath, and some thick-cut local bacon.
Crispy bacon.
Crispy bacon.
Yes.
Yay.
Yes.
Enjoy.
Thank you so much. Oh, wow. Let's see if we can hear the crunch. Ready?
Oh, yeah.
My name is Crystal Lair. We own Krista's Restaurant in Cornish, Maine. And we've been here since 2004. We're a funky little eatery in a cute little village that you gotta come visit.
I wonder why people stop us on the street everywhere and say, all you guys do is eat. I don't know why they would say that, but.
Wow. That's an ice cream cookie?
That is one serving of an ice cream cookie sandwich.
That whole thing together?
Yes.
Hi, my name is Sarah Jenkins, and this is my restaurant, 9 of June. I grew up in Italy, so it's a restaurant that's really about Italian food. We shop around with all the farms and local seafood and local meat when we can, and create a menu out of what the bounty of Maine gives us.
Like, it doesn't get much better.
I mean, seriously.
Mm. Another romantic evening with Aaron O'Valley.
As if we haven't had enough food today.
Love you guys.
Love you.
Maine life. Yum.
More manja.
Mm. Oh my God.
Oh, wow.
Thanks so much for watching this episode of Maine Life. To follow our adventures, you can check out our social media, Maine Life Media, or our Instagram at Aaron O'Valley. Thank you to our sponsors and New Center Maine. And don't forget to support our music contributors, Ghost of Paul Revere. Go to their website, buy some swag, or sign up for their Patreon. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.
I said I told you I'm angry and I ain't coming back no more.